In this video, we're going to learn how to add borders to photographs in Photoshop. We're going to start by adding some simple line borders around the edge of our photograph and then finish off by doing a more ornate flourish style border where we're going to have to cut out our photograph to make it fit inside. But to start with, here's how you add a really simple line border towards the edge of your photo. Make sure you have your photograph layer selected in your layers panel just by clicking on it, and then go over to the right hand side of the layer and we're just going to double click and it's going to bring up the layer styles. Look down the list on the left hand side until you get to an option that says stroke and then click on that. That stroke will add a border around the edge of your photo. You can use the options in this pop-up window to change the thickness of the border and also the colour down the bottom. You can either change the colour by clicking the different colours in the pop-up, or you can move your mouse over to your design and use the colour picker by clicking to get an exact colour from your image. When you're happy with the colour, click OK, and this takes us back to all of the different stroke options. Now on the border that this is applied, it's got really straight, proper corners on the border. And the reason for that is the position is set to inside. So it's put the line inside my photo. If I change it to outside, that line will go around the outside of my photo. And this means that it gives the corners a little rounded effect on the edge instead. So you can choose which one you prefer, or if you want something that's in the middle, choose center as the position, and this is kind of 50% between inside and outside. When you're happy with how your border's looking, click OK. And now your photograph has a simple line border around the edge of it. But what if you want to do something that's a little bit more exciting than just a simple line? Well, you can do that too. I'm just going to remove this border because we're going to be adding a different one. So I'm going to right click on my layer in the layers palette and hit clear layer style to remove that stroke. Now I've already found a border that I want to use, and I'll put a link to where you can download this image underneath the video so that you can go and grab it if you want to use this one too. I'm going to select everything in this file by clicking Ctrl and A and then Ctrl and C to copy. I'm going to go back over to my puppy's image and Ctrl and V to paste. Now my frame that I've put on here is much bigger than the size of the image I'm working on, so I need to make it smaller. I'm going to zoom out by pressing Ctrl and minus on my keyboard to make this a little bit easier, and then with my move tool selected, which is the top one in your tools, and then the show transform controls button at the top ticked, I'm going to go to one of the corners on this bounding box and just click and drag to resize. Now because I'm using Photoshop 2019, all I have to do to resize and keep it in proportion is just click and drag these corners. If you're using a version of Photoshop that's older than Creative Cloud 2019, then you'll need to hit the shift key when you're resizing, otherwise the frame won't stay in its square shape. Okay, so now I've made the frame quite a bit smaller, I'm going to zoom in a bit. And then I'm just going to make it a little bit smaller still. And then I want it to be right in the middle of my design. So I'm going to use the move tool and just watch until I get pink lines appear. And these are grid lines. So when you've got one that appears down the top and one that applies vertically and horizontally, that shows that your frame is now directly in the middle. So hopefully you can see those little pink lines have showed up. Okay, so now I'm happy with where my frame is. It's right in the middle, and I am happy with the size. So I'm going to hit enter on my keyboard to apply that resize. Okay, so if I just hide the transform controls so we can see a bit better. I've now resized the frame, but it's not looking great at the minute because the edges of my photograph are showing outside the edges of the frame. So what I want to do is cut out the photo so that only the middle bit is left. I'm going to go back to my tools palette on the left and look down until I find the magic wand tool, which is the fourth one down. I'm going to click on that one. And then with my my frame, my border layer selected in the layers palette, I'm going to go over to the middle of the frame and just single click. What that's done is it has selected that space inside of the frame. Now if I was to delete this part of the photo, it would delete the part from the center of the frame, which is actually the bit I want to keep. So I need to reverse my selection so that I'm only going to delete the parts that are outside the frame. To do this, go to Select in the top menu and then click Inverse. Now it's selected everything outside of the frame, which is the part I want to delete. So in my layers palette, I can click on my photograph layer, and then on my keyboard, I'm just going to hit delete. And now that's deleted everything outside of the frame. So if I go over to my marquee tool and then just click away to get rid of those marching ants, you can see that the photo is now cut out perfectly to sit inside of the frame. As one last little bit of decoration before I finish this video, we can also recolor that border so that it fits better with the colors in our design. So I'm going to select my border layer in the layers palette and then double click on that layer on the right hand side in the layers palette to bring up our layer styles again. I'm going to go down to where it says color overlay, and then I'm going to click into the color box in the middle, bring my mouse over to my design, and just find a color from inside my design that works well for the frame border. And I kind of like that, but I think it needs to be a bit darker. So I'm just going to use my mouse to click a bit of a darker color. And then click OK and OK again. And now that's recolored my border, so it's matching with the colors better. And we've got our beautiful photo of these gorgeous puppies all cut out inside their ornate frame.